Boys could be allowed to wear skirts at Highgate School if a plan for gender-neutral uniforms comes in. The private school is also considering mix-and-match outfits for pupils after head teachers said growing numbers of children were questioning their gender. The school has also been encouraged to allow unisex toilets and open all sports to all pupils. So, Angela, let's start with you, first of all, because you don't agree with this. You think this is nothing but confusing.
I think it's absolutely appalling. I think it's the worst kind of social engineering. I mean, we're actively encouraging children, and they're still children, to question their identity and their gender. Now, setting aside that, I'm sure there is a small cohort of people who, you know, feel desperately sort of sad and confused about being trapped in the wrong body or have very specific issues. This is a kind of real blunt instrument, a one-size-fits-all approach, very much powered by a vocal kind of woolly liberal lobby now that are saying that all children should have the right to question their identity. A lot of kids are confused at that age for all sorts of reasons, and some will grow out of it, some will not. You know, some kids want to be firemen, some kids want to be actresses. You know, and what I think is even worse is for the school to sort of actively take on this value and promote it to children without any kind of responsibility. I think it's a real dereliction of duty. You know, as parents, we put up with the backlash from all of this as well. And, I mean, you can chuckle as much as you like, but as a parent, you know, you might not appreciate. This is how it feels. And this is typically why it's so difficult to debate it, because anybody who takes the so-called sensible or conservative view is seen as somehow being wacko because we're not sort of understanding that children are very vulnerable and susceptible to all sorts of ideas. I think it's wrong for institutions like schools to promote that.
Well, Paris, actually, why are you sniggering?
I'd really like to talk about vulnerable children, actually, Angela, because I read an article that you wrote for The Telegraph where you described childhood as a lovely time where you just got to explore yourself and it was a time of innocence, and it was very lovely, right, from what you described.
Yes, OK. I was talking about my own children's childhood.
Well, I'm very happy for them. My childhood, I was bullied violently at school for years. I was also bullied at home. I'd often get a clip around the ear hole from my dad who'd say, why are you talking like an effing puff? Or why do you walk like a sissy? And actually, this is how a lot of kids feel who express their gender differently. So,
I'm not denying that there are people
well,
that were in your situation.
Excuse me. No, it's my turn to speak now.
I know that, but I'm not denying that.
Well, okay, so you're appalled. You're appalled that a school is going to give boys the option to wear skirts.
Yeah,
why aren't you appalled by the 48% of young trans people that are driven to attempt suicide? We're not talking about contemplated suicide, attempted suicide. This is the reality of what these kids are going through. It's not something you've been through. It's not something that I'm guessing your children are going through. So what right have you got to come on here and say that anybody else hasn't got a right to dress however they want to? We've got more important things to be worrying about in the world than what clothes people are wearing.
Well, first of all, I have a right because I'm entitled to my opinion.
Well, you're entitled to your opinion, but I'm entitled to wear what I want, and other kids are entitled to wear what they want. So you can dress your kids wearing whatever they want to go to school. But if I have kids, it's going to be none of your bloody business what they wear to school.
And when you go to school, the whole point about uniform is it's there for uniformity. It's there, and why should this lobby be driving...
Girls can wear trousers, why can't boys wear
skirts? Because, well, if you look at the history of why girls wear trousers, a lot of it was not about equality, it was about comfort, it was about health, it was about safety, ironically. Women felt more secure wearing trousers, you know. I mean,
you keep using the word promoter. Schools are promoting this, they're promoting this, and they're not really promoting it as such as making it less of an issue in a way, isn't it?
No, they are making it an issue because if school has a mandate...
But only because it's a change. But eventually that change will become the norm. And so maybe it's not this generation, but the next generation where it will become so normal that it won't be seen... If you think of the changes that we've made, like even wearing trousers, even girls wearing trousers at school...
I don't agree with that.
Well,
that's a separate conversation. Just because I think it's less smart.
But what I'm saying is, there are things that we do and live now that are accepted that years and years and years ago would have seemed like on another planet.
Without question, I agree with you, Holly, and we have to evolve culturally, emotionally, and as a community.
Isn't this part of it?
No, I don't think it is. I think what's happened is there has been a kind of disproportionate response to a small number of people who, understandably, and have every sympathy with the kind of background that Paris has. We all have difficulties in our backgrounds for different reasons. We can't sort of ape a victim culture and say, because I felt like this, we have to have this level playing field whereby children who wouldn't even consider questioning their gender identity are suddenly thrown into this situation.
Here from Paris here. If a school is... Why are you rolling your eyes?
I just find the whole thing completely ridiculous. Like, you're offended.
We're debating it. It's not ridiculous.
Okay, but you're offended because you're sick of people like me who don't believe that you should be saying these things. I'm sick of people like you saying that people like me shouldn't be able to.
Okay, so let's conclude that you're both sick of each other. And let me ask you another question. Paris.
I don't have a right to wear what I want at school.
Paris. Can I ask you, if with something like this, which you think is a really good idea, the problem is in that transitional period of incorporating a new idea is that everybody has to get on board. Mm-hmm. So if some of those pupils are not on board and one of their friends turns up in a skirt because they've decided that is the identity I want, doesn't that make life harder for them?
What, for the child? Well, I guess so, but by that same argument, people would say, well, maybe gay people shouldn't have kids because their children would be bullied. The problem isn't that people are different. The problem is the bullying and that we've got a culture that doesn't accept it. So if everybody chilled out about it, it wouldn't be a big deal. What difference does it make if kids go to school? If actually we teach people to celebrate difference and respect everybody for who they are.